So tomorrow is going to be a big day, because it's the first time in about 4 weeks I'm going to be running a progression run, something a bit faster, and hopefully this injury will settle down and I'll be able to push on in my training. Fingers crossed. You're going to join me. Here we go. Before I go out for a run, I'm going to try and go through as much of the kit as I can with you guys, because I think kit is a big thing in terms of what people like to see. When you're vlogging, they like to know what trains you're in, what shorts you're wearing, what vest you're wearing, t-shirt, etc. Today is a very hot day here in North Devon. It's about 20-odd-ish degrees, 21, 22 degrees. Where I'm sat right now, the wind is right behind me, so it's like I'm sat in Mallorca or somewhere quite nice right now. So, trainers I'm going to wear tomorrow. I'm going to go for these bad boys. So these are the Hoka Carbon X. They are version 2, so they're not the brand new ones, the version 2s. But the reason I'm going for something like this is that, again, I know it works for me. Hoka, as you guys know, I quite like the Hoka. I like the Hoka range at the moment, how you cradle your foot. I don't think it's the fastest trainer on the market. That's one thing. I definitely don't think it is. But it does offer a little bit more energy back. But then it's also a comfortable option for me as well. It's not something I'd wear on an easy day. It's something I'd wear on literally what I'm going to do tomorrow. So a progression run, something that's going to start a little bit easier and then ramp right up to like 5:30, 5:15 per a mile pace. And I know this trainer can perform at that pace quite comfortably. And I know I don't get any hot spots, any blisters or anything like that. So when you're picking a trainer, obviously make sure it's the right one for you. Don't go straight into a trainer that you haven't actually ran in before. I'm presuming it's going to be hot again tomorrow. So shorts wise, I'm going to go for a company that I absolutely love at the moment, which is Saw. So I'm going to go for the speed shorts, Saw. I think these are 2.0s or something like that, elites. Super lightweight short, split short, no real pockets on it. These aren't the marathon shorts with the bands around them, around the waist. These are just the ones with the zip on the back. So I'm going to go for those. And then last of all, I'm going to go for, which is inside out at the moment, I'm going to go for this bad boy, the Sort Elite race vest. Absolutely superb bit of kit, taped in every seam, 39 grams of pure performance. I'm a massive fan of this vest. So I'm going to go for the shorts, I'm going to go for the vest, I'm going to go for the semi-carbon trainers, not the super duper foam, but something that can give me a bit of a plush pump, and I know that's going to suit me. And then we're going to see how we get on. I'm super excited for tomorrow. I'll eat well tonight, sleep well, and then I aim to go out tomorrow about 10 a.m. and hopefully you guys are going to join me for a little bit of it at least. I'll tell you what my pre-run and my post-run thoughts are. Fingers crossed we get through this and it will feel good at the end of it. Here we go. Good morning, everyone. Today is Friday, the 3rd of June, and I'm about to do my first harder running. So I've got a progression run this morning. It's going to be dropping down from like 7 to 6:30s, 6:15s, and then dropping all the way down to like 5:30s, 5:15s for the last couple of miles. It's the fastest stuff I've done for about 4 or 5 weeks now, so I'm very excited. A little bit nervous at the same time, like I was saying last night. I think everyone that's had an injury, you're always playing on your mind a little bit, thinking, oh God, is it going to be there? Am I going to feel it, etc.? But hopefully it'll go well. I'm going to have a good warm up now, good stretch out right here in Biddeford, where I'm going to hit onto the Targa Trail. Going to the Targa Trail, if you don't know what a Targa Trail is, it's a super flat, boring piece of tarmac, but it is flat and it's quite chill today. It's not super windy, so I can't, well, it doesn't look like I'm going to be able to blame the wind if I don't hit the times too much today. Fingers crossed, here we go. Gonna do a bit of a warm up, chill out, bit of a stretch, bit of a flex, and then we're gonna get on the road. I'm just about to do a little jog warm up now. I'm not particularly bothered on pace. I will tell you one thing though, it's not even 9 o'clock here in North Devon and it is absolutely boiling. So I don't normally like to go too early for fast running. Sometimes I have to just because of the little one, but today I'm hoping it's actually the right call in terms of going out at this time in the morning because it's very, very warm. I'm gonna run towards Insta if any of you guys know that way and then back again. But yeah, very warm. I'm looking forward to it. I'm actually gonna do a bit of filming with the GoPro, but not a huge amount just because I really wanna hit this session. So you're gonna kind of see the pre, which is this, a little bit of it, and then the post, which I'll give you my thoughts on how it went and give you the times, etc. But yeah, we just enjoy this little warm up for a minute, nice and chilled, nothing too hard. Rock along this Tarka trail. Just to tell you what the session is, it's 8 mile in total. 7 minute mile for 1 mile, 6:45 for the next, then we jump, so we miss 6:30, then 6:15, 6, 5:45, 5:30, 5:15, all flat, no elevation, just flat, fast running. So we'll see how that goes. Not long now, here we go, let's go. Yesterday now, so it is now Saturday and I'm just going on for my easy run after yesterday's session. I didn't really conclude yesterday's session too well because there was lots going on and I had to get back basically. So today is I'm going to try and conclude yesterday's session a little bit and how it went, and you're going to run with me a little bit. I'm hoping the wind will settle down and it's not going to be so windy that you can't hear me. So yesterday's session, I completed it, it was 8 mile, like I say, progression, so it got quicker and quicker and quicker. Got to 5:45 per mile, started to feel it then, heart rate was certainly higher than what it normally is, as you can imagine. And as I got down to 5:30, I think I quickly realised that this is where I'm at, this is where my fitness is at. It's not a bad thing, 5:30 per mile. But just started feeling a bit of a pinch and wasn't feeling smooth. I think that's what it is. Wasn't feeling smooth, wasn't going through the motion particularly. Just wasn't able to go any quicker. So the 5:15 last mile was a bit
blah, it didn't really happen. They kind of just progressed into another 5:30 or 5:33 per mile pace. Still two very solid miles there though. You know, 5:30 is still an achievement. This is the view right behind me. Not too bad, is it? And I'm working my way all the way down to the end of Westwood Ho. We're gonna swing around and then pretty much go back very similar way to where we come. Again, keeping it nice and chilled, nice and flat today. Not massively looking at watching, even though I just did, but I'm not very bothered at all. Nice and easy running. And just try and enjoy it as much as I can. We're all downhill from now, pretty much. Still feeling good, legs feeling okay. A little bit tired, wind's a bit annoying, but apart from that, it's all good. Blessed to be running again. When you're out of running for so long, you feel so bad not running, and you just want to, that's all you want to do, isn't it? Is just run. You can do as many other sports as you want, but at the end of the day, nothing compares to running. It's just the way it is. Love running. Ah, run done. Job done. So that was a 5 mile, about 17-ish pace, 7:20 pace. So again, didn't look at the watch, just really chilled out. We did hit a little hill at one point, which did knock out the legs a bit, but we're back home now. And like I say, as always, grab that protein shake, grab a recovery shake, and then go again. I think it's really important when you've had an injury, that's even more important than ever, is to try and get that nutrition in as quick as you can. Prepare those muscles, prepare those fibres, and go again. Hope the next day. Not sure what tomorrow's going to include. I've got to chat to my coach. That was a big session yesterday in terms of a big step forward in terms of my injury. 8 mile progression today, 5 mile easy, and I'm still walking. I'm all limping. Can't particularly feel it, you know, this is a big thumbs up. So training's felt good, the old Fokker edge, there they are, in a funny colourway, but I'm not sure about that colour, it's all about the price, isn't it? So yeah, they felt quite good, to be honest. They suit the Hocker Clifton 8 really well as well. They just offer that little bit, maybe more plushness, a little bit more up-tempo trainer, but I wouldn't say it's a super fast trainer, it's really right. So yeah, we're going now. We'll chill out, we'll enjoy the rest of the day, bank holiday weekend, and I will I'll catch you guys soon. Hope you're all well. Give it a like, give it a subscribe, always helps the situation, helps me bring more content, and also allows me to know how many people are actually enjoying it. Have a good day.